Welcome everybody. How y'all guys doing? This is Prophetess Kimberly Hargraves. I'm the founder of Rejoice Essential Magazines, also Christian Arthur. Good morning everybody. How was y'all Thanksgiving? I know it was early in the morning, but to God be the glory. Y'all got a lot to be, thankful for. So, I'm also doing a Facebook Live. How you doing, Miss April? Yes, I'm doing a Facebook Live. I'm going to start talking about my books more often. So I just want to encourage you. God is moving. God bless you, Samira. I emailed you back, woman of God. Yes. How do you feel? Did you feel the fire in that prayer? Because when I was praying for you, woman of God, I felt heat. So I believe. How you doing, Jeanette? Yeah, I believe that God has healed you. Hallelujah. If you didn't feel the fire, then we're going to pray. Samira, I don't know if you feel, you felt something move. Look at God. Hallelujah. Yeah, we're going to also pray again. Before I get off here, I'm going to pray for your miracle. All right. So welcome everybody. How you doing, Miss Juanita? So, God is good. Listen, y'all, today I want to be talking about how you doing, Dr. SD Dreyer. How you doing? God bless you, Willie. Welcome everybody. So, I want to talk about how you doing, Prophet Foster. How you doing, BJ Sox? How you doing, Prophetess Melody in the house? How you doing, Lady Shavita? How you doing? So today we're going to talk about one of my books, In Right Standing. And I just want to encourage you guys. A lot of people, you are hurting. A lot of people, you feel discouraged. A lot of people, you're waiting like, God, Lord, when is going to happen? Happy belated Thanksgiving, because it was yesterday, but happy Thanksgiving. All right. So I want to encourage you guys. So I have written 10 books. I'm writing my 11th one now, Walking by Faith, a daily devotional. So I'm excited about that. Woo, woo. It should be out the middle of next month. So I just give God praise for that. So I remember writing this book, y'all, and it's so important to worship. When I began to worship the Lord, the glory of God came into my room and he pinned me down to the floor. Listen, a lot of people, when you feel frustrated, you want those ideas to flow. Let me tell you something. When you worship God, how you doing, Dad? My dad is watching me on Facebook Live. How you doing, Daddy? I love you. All right. So when you begin to worship God, I'm telling you, the heavens will open up over your head and you will get an idea. God will give you an idea, to change the course of your life. Amen. So I began to worship the Lord one day. My eyes began to open and he handed me a scepter. And he says, here, daughter, I want you to teach on righteousness. I'm doing good, Ashton. And, at the time, like 2 years ago, I had no idea what righteousness was. So then the Lord gave me a revelation and it changed my life. When I'm talking about when I saw more healings manifest, when I got that revelation of righteousness, when I saw people get delivered like never before in this ministry, that's when I got the revelation of righteousness. Amen. And it was just amazing. So it changed my life. God is calling his people into righteousness. Amen. God wants you to live righteous. It's nothing wrong, with living righteously. All right. So we're going to talk about that. All right. I'm telling you, yep. Righteousness changed everything. It changed the course of my life. So we're going to get into this. I pretty much break it down, what righteousness is and the benefits of righteousness. All right. So we're going to talk about this. And if you got this book, we're going to read from page 93 out of this book today, and then we're going to pray, and at the end, I'm going to take some prayer requests or whatever the Holy Spirit leads, all right? But I just want to tell you guys, don't forget to join tonight. Tonight, we're going to have a prophetic miracle call. Our prophetic miracle call, when I say signs and wonders happen on that call, it happens on that call, amen? So it's going to be tonight at 9 p.m. if you stay on Pacific Standard Time, you stay on the mountains, 10 p.m., 11 p.m. if you stay on Central Standard Time, and midnight for those on the East Coast time, it's going to go down. I need you to get your communions together. God has given me a right now word for somebody. All right, that's right. Amen. I like that. 2017, a year coming into righteousness. Amen. All right, so it's going to go down tonight. All right, and signs and wonders will follow. So God has, on that call, he has opened up deaf ears. He has, straightened scoliosis, lumps dissolve in people's bodies. So I just give God praise for that. All right, so it's going to go down. A lot of people like, Prophetess, what is God saying? I need a word. I'm telling you, I will help you seek the throne room of God tonight. And I know God will fill my mouth up for you. All right, if you're seeking for a prophetic word. If you're sick, call in tonight. And all the information is on my website. It's on my profile, KimberlyHargraves.com. And just go to that. So we're going to get into this. Amen. So Listen, I asked you a question in this book on page 93. I asked you, do you want everything that God has for you? You know, the key is to walk blamelessly or righteously. Amen. Because we already know what the word says. No good thing will God will hold from you if you walk uprightly. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? A lot of people right now, like, God, I want a promotion on my job. God, I want a better job, God. God, I want to get married again, God. I want to get married, Lord God. God, I want a financial blessing. Let me tell you something. No good thing will God will hold from you if you walk uprightly. I don't know who I'm preaching to today. Amen. But if you've been walking uprightly, if you've been obedient to God and obeying everything he has told you to do, just get ready. Can I prophesy and tell you to get ready? Hallelujah. You are in position. You are in position to receive from God. Hallelujah. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? You are in position. That's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's right. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes, that's right, Melody. Yes, about a Seth. I receive it, woman of God. Whatever God has given me, I receive it in the realm of the spirit. So, listen, let me tell you something. Some of you frustrated, don't take the bait of frustration. Some of you feel overlooked, like, God, I'm doing everything right. Your season is coming. Your season is coming to receive your harvest. A lot of people, you have been constantly sowing and sowing and sowing. Just get ready to reap. I don't think you just heard what I said. Get ready to reap. I want to decree and declare that you're getting ready to reap things, you know, reap in places that you have not sown in. You know, I'm telling you, the harvest is ripe. That is a word for somebody. Your harvest is ripe. And I'm telling you, you know, don't give up. Do not give up, because this could be your day. This is a brand new day. Yesterday's trouble was yesterday, but this is a brand new day. Your harvest is ripe. Come on now, just get ready to receive, all right? Listen, you know, a lot of people, you've been praying for a long time. You have been praying, fasting, seeking the face of God for a long time. Just get ready. Just get ready to receive, amen? So you can't give up, all right? So, and I'm reading out of page 93 out of my book, In Right Standing. It's a daily devotional, all right? So, you know, the Lord, Psalms 84:11, amen? Psalms 84:11, I need you to meditate on this. I need you to meditate on this and bring it to your prayer closet. All right, for the Lord God is a sun and shield. You know, he bestows favor and honor. Amen? No good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. Listen, I want you to decree and declare that God is going to bestow favor upon you. He's going to bestow favor upon you. Amen? Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Thank you, Dad, for sharing. Hallelujah. So listen, a lot of people, you need favor for God to open up doors that have been shut. You need favor, you know, for connections. You need favor for God to do something in your life that's amazing, something that you couldn't even possibly do for yourself. You need favor. Not only do you need favor with God, but you need favor with men. Amen? You need favor with influential people. You need favor, you know, to magnetize wealth. You need favor. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Continue to walk uprightly before God. Continue to say, okay, God, when you go in your prayer closet before God, okay, God, what's on your heart today, God? God, what's on your agenda today, God? God, how can I please you, God? What can I do, Lord God? God, use me, Lord God. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Sometimes we go to God and it's all about us. But do we ever take the time out and say, what's up, Lord God? You know, bless you, God. God, I love you, God. God, I need you, Lord God. Sorry, I got a puppy and he's just acting up, but I rebuke that in Jesus' name. Listen, so just continue to walk uprightly. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? So I need somebody to put up here right now. I am going to walk uprightly before the Lord. I am going to walk uprightly before the Lord. Do you hear what I'm saying? You know, see, the enemy is trying to distract some of y'all. The enemy is trying to put people in your path right now to make you stumble, to make you sin against God, to make you compromise. But I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. Good morning, Shanika. Amen. So listen, we're going to walk uprightly. Somebody just say, I'm going to continue to walk uprightly before God. All right? Because I need everything that God has for me. I need everything that God has for me. Listen, you don't understand. Look, a lot of people, you're getting persecuted for doing the right thing. You are blessed. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? So what if they talked about you? They talked about Jesus, you know? But the word of God says Listen, you are blessed when they falsely persecute you and say all kind of evil things against you for Jesus' sake. You are blessed, for great is your reward in heaven. You are blessed because they persecuted the prophets, you know, that were before you. You are blessed. Somebody needs to know that you are blessed. Continue to walk rightly before God. And when you have a demand, you know, a lot of people, you have a demand right now. You have a need. God, we put a demand on you today that every need on here will be met in Jesus' name. Amen. And when you walk uprightly, when you have a need, God is not going to withhold that thing from you. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Some people, you have a need. God, I need my rent paid. Hallelujah. Lord, God, I need my rent paid. God, I need God, you to do this for me, Lord God. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. God is going to do it. Do you hear what I'm saying? Continue to do the right thing. Don't get distracted. Don't sell out. Amen. Don't sell out to the ways of the world. Don't compromise. Amen. Do not compromise. Don't take the bait of the enemy. That's why I continue to walk rightly, uprightly before God. All right. So God wants to give you honor. Amen. God wants to give you favor. You know, he wants to give you the best gifts. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Don't settle. A lot of people, you've been settling too long. Do not settle. Amen. Listen, you need to look in the mirror and see yourself. This is somebody's prayer today. Say, God, show me how, you know, Lord, let me look at myself, how you see me. Lord, let me look at myself how you see me. You need to look in the mirror and see yourself the way God sees you. God says, you're my child, and I want to bless you with the best gifts. Amen? You are the Lord's child, so why are you settling? Why are you settling? Amen? Listen, you know God has more for you. Some people, you became complacent in this walk. You say, okay, God, nothing good ever happens for me anyways. So why keep on praying? Why keep on trying? No, you got to keep on fighting this thing. You know, we are in a battle. We are in the Lord's army. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Nobody never said this walk was going to be easy. Nobody never said this walk was going to be peaches and cream. You got to go through something. Amen? Listen, you're looking at someone that went through something. Amen? I done went through the fire and back. I done got persecuted. I done served leaders that didn't even like me. You know what I'm saying? Just crazy stuff that I went through. You know, I went through an eviction. I went through a bad divorce. But listen, I'm still standing. And when I have a need, I put a demand on God and say, God, I have a need from you. I've been walking uprightly. And therefore, God, I know you're going to provide for me, God. God, I know you're going to sustain me, God. And he has been doing it ever since. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? That's right, Dad. Walk uprightly before the Lord. I'm telling you, nothing, you know, that you need from God will be withheld from you if you walk uprightly. I don't know if y'all getting what I'm saying to you. You know, I feel, you know, a spirit of righteousness being released. I feel faith being released. I feel hope being released. I feel peace being released. I need you to receive it, people of God. I need you to receive everything that God has for you. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? But the key is righteousness. Amen. I don't care. I don't care about those lukewarm Christians. I don't care about those people that's compromising against God. That's not going to be our testimony. That's not, you know, what we're a part of. Amen. We're going to please God. Amen. We're not going to be a friend of the world, because the word of God says if we're a friend of the world, we're an enemy to God. Amen. Listen to me, people of God. We're going to be on fire for God. We're going to get our zeal back for God. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? We're going to put a demand on heaven. Hallelujah. Some people, right now, you want miracle finances. You want favor. You know, you want just things that's just blessings. You want God to bless you as never before. You need to walk uprightly before God. You need, that's right, you need to withhold the standard. Hallelujah. Don't compromise. Don't try to even blend in with the world. God has set you apart for such a time as this. You know what I'm saying? You're never going to fit in. So why are you trying to blend in with the world? Come on, somebody. Let your light shine brightly before men so they can, you know, glorify God when they see your good deeds. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? You look, you are a city. You are a light on a hill. You know, I'm telling you, and don't hide that light. Let that light shine brightly. Amen. Let that light shine brightly. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? This is Holy Spirit leading me here. I'm not even reading out the book. My God, somebody, the Lord has really been convicting you. And he said, I need you to get this thing together. Hallelujah. You know, you go to church, you put on the front, but your heart is far from him. And this right now, this is a divine appointment for you. You need to repent and say, God, I'm going to get this thing right, because you're seeking secret life is different from your public life. Amen. And nothing that is hidden, you know, God sees it all. Amen. You might try to hide, you know, but God is looking at you. Amen. Listen to me. We're going to get this thing right today, people. Amen. You know, you're going to get this thing right. So listen. So Matthew 7:11. Write this down. Because some people feel discouraged. Some people feel really, really discouraged. Hallelujah. You know, if then you are being evil, you know how to give gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven, you know, give good gifts to those who ask him? You know, listen. We serve a good God. Crazy about you? Don't you know that God desires to bless you? Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Listen, you know, the word of God says, fret not of the evildoers. It seems like some people are getting frustrated because it seems like the people in the world are prospering more than you, but that's just a mirage. Those people are not happy. You got something special in the inside. You got the Holy Spirit in the inside of you. Do you hear what I'm saying? You got the Comforter living inside of you. You hear what I'm saying? You got the Prince of Peace dwelling in your midst. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? He's going to keep you in perfect peace in that storm. He's going to keep you in perfect peace when all that chaos is around you and all that hectic is around you. He will keep you in perfect peace, so you don't have to fret not of the wicked. Okay, you don't have to fret not. You don't have to be jealous of the people in the world looking, seeming like they prosper more than you. Let me tell you something. Your time is coming. Your time is coming. Continue to walk uprightly before God. Continue to keep doing the right thing. I pray this is, if this blessing you, say this is blessing me. Say this is blessing me. Too many times, you know, I've been compromised. I've been lukewarm. But God wants me to tell you this day to get on fire, to get hot. Hallelujah for him. Amen. Because the word of God says, you know, it's better to be cold or hot. You know, I'm going to spit you out from my mouth, amen, if you're lukewarm. Listen, you know, I pray this is stirring you up. I need you to get stirred up today. God has an amazing plan for you. Somebody, you know, you're just this close away from the biggest miracle that has hit your life. All right? That's right. I like that. God, yes, that's right. Amen. So, you know, God, he wants to give you your heart's desires. Amen. Continue to delight yourself in him. Because the word of God says if you delight yourself in him, he's going to give you the desires of your heart. Amen. God is faithful. All right. Jesus, he is so faithful to us. Listen, I want to decree and declare today that every deadline, you know, a lot of people are like, God, I got laid off on my job. Lord God, they walked out on me. Lord God, the burdens on me is too heavy. And I need this to be done by this amount of time. I want to decree and declare today that God is going to meet every deadline. I don't think you heard what I just said. God is going to meet every deadline that you have in your life. I'm a living witness. Listen to me, people of God. You know, before I got into full-time ministry, hallelujah, and I had a secular job working in the hospital, and I knew that something was happening. There was a shaking taking place in my life. Listen to me. A lot of people right now, you're being shaken. Everything that could have went wrong has gone wrong, but this is the time where the Lord is strengthening your faith, because God says, I need you to look to me. I'm going to provide for you. Do you trust me to come through and provide for you? Listen, last year, you know, my secular job, you know, when I worked in the hospital, it was just being shaken, you know, and I just like I couldn't get any hours from work, and I was like, God, I got these bills due, and it was just crazy. But let me tell you something, I cried out to God. The word of God says, hey, when the righteous cry out to God for help, listen to me, when the righteous cry out to God for help, he's going to deliver us from all our troubles. Many are the affliction of the righteous, but God delivers them from us all. Amen. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? All right, and the word of God says, in your distress, he will give you, come on now, you know, he's going to give you rest in your distress. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? God is going to give you rest in your stressful situation if you trust him. Yeah, you're being shaken. Yeah, you may be in prune right now. Yeah, you're being stripped, and it doesn't feel good. Sometimes it's painful, my God, but you need to trust God in this process and continue to do everything right, because let me tell you something. Listen, you're getting ready to go from rags to riches. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Some of you, you know, you need new things. Your shoes raggedy, your clothes raggedy, you stay in a raggedy pace, but you You're getting ready to go from rags to riches. You're getting ready to go from, you know, from poor to being prosperous. You're getting ready to go from being overlooked to being seen somebody. You're getting ready to be, you know, just getting everything that God has for you. You're getting ready to go from lack into more than enough. Amen. Your cup is really getting ready to run over and overflow. Continue to walk uprightly. Amen. Receive it. Receive it. All right. So Proverbs 10:6. I'm almost done, people of God. Proverbs 10:6. It says, blessings. Listen, blessings. We're going to put the man on God today. God, I need you to demonstrate this word. Write this down, and I need you to pray this word back into God and ask God to demonstrate this word. Do you hear what I'm saying? Woman of God, hallelujah. You may be tired of being overlooked, but I heard one word for you, and that's this word is from Laquita. The Lord says overflow. When I looked at you, I saw overflow. Amen. I saw overflow. God says, I want to use you to finance my kingdom. I want to use you. I've been speaking to about you about wealth and riches and about financial prosperity in your life. You know, so just get ready to receive it. Yeah, you may be overlooked, but God says, I was just testing you. Amen. He said he was just testing you. He said he was just seeing the motives that were in your heart. And that word is for you, LaQuinta 1. That word is for you. Amen. So be faithful. Be faithful. And I don't even know if you're in ministry or not, but this is a great call on your life, you know, to do the work of the Lord. There's a great call on your life, you know, favor. I'm telling you, don't you know how much favor you have, woman of God? You have favor. You know, you're the kind of person that people look at you and they say you're blessed, you know, but you don't even feel like you're blessed. Listen to me. You are blessed. You know, you look at yourself, everybody around you can see the blessing and the favor of God on your life, but you. I'm going to be honest with you today. You know, look at yourself the way God looks at you. Amen. You are blessed. Hallelujah. And God says, woman of God, it's time for you to come forward. It's time for you to come forward because you are a powerful woman of God. You are anointed and you got even healing in your hands. This word is from LaQuinta 1. You even got healing in your hands. And the Lord said, I'm going to use you, my daughter. I'm going to use you and I'm going to put you and I'm going to push you to the forefront. Hallelujah. And you know, don't be surprised, you know, and I hate to prophesy 2017, but I hear it. 2017, woman of God, things are going to open up for you. Amen. If I be a prophet of God, things are going to open up for you. I see you standing in front of a congregation. I see you with a mic in your hand in the realm of the spirit. I see you. You have like some kind of program or something in your hand, like you're reading announcements or something like that. I see you, woman of God. I see you, woman of God. I see you, woman of God. Hallelujah. That's what I see you, woman of God. A spirit of boldness is going to hit you right now. God is going to say, I need you to be confident and I need you to trust me because it's me that speaks to you, you know, and sometimes it's like cloudiness in your mind, but I send forth the fire of God to come against any cloudiness in your mind and you're going to begin to be confident in the voice of God. You're going to be confident in hearing the voice of the Lord when he speaks to you. Do you hear what I'm saying to you, LaQuinta 1? And I pray this is making sense because I don't know you. I don't know you. Amen. Listen, hallelujah. So listen, I'm telling you, Jesus, hallelujah. That's right. Surrender it all to God. Surrender it all to God. You got to die to self. Amen. It's a lot. This is a word for a lot of people on here. You want God to move through you as never before? Die to self and watch God pour out a strong anointing on your life. Watch God, you know, the supernatural flow through you as never before. Amen. All right, so let me just get through this because I can stay on here and I can prophesy. Whew, gee, okay, listen. We're going to have a prophetic miracle call tonight. Call in tonight. Go to my website. Get the number. I don't know it by heart. I just got a new number. Amen. And I'm going to pray for each and every one of you, you know, within a certain amount of time. You know, get there early. All right, 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 10 p.m. if you stay on the mountains, 11 p.m. Central Standard Time, and midnight if you stay on the East Coast time. We're going to take communion. All right, all the times are on my website. Just go to my website. Amen. Listen to me, people of God. Listen, God is moving. I feel the fire of God burning in somebody's belly today. God is moving. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? You know, listen, Jesus. All God wants us to do is just believe. You know, a lot of people, you want to figure out how God's going to do this. God, it don't make sense. You spoken something to me. You sent your prophet to speak something in my life, and I can't even see this thing taking into fruition. But God is saying, hey, like I always tell you guys, you know, you need him to get it done. Because listen to me, God has given a lot of people a vision way bigger than you, and you can't do it by yourself. God is going to send you people to support you and help you get the vision done. God is going to give you the funds to get it done. Amen. But the reason why God gave you this assignment, this mandate that was bigger than you, because he wants you to trust him. He wants you to trust. That's right. God has given some of us a million, multi-million dollar vision. And you know, I'm just like, God, Jesus. But listen to me. As you continue to fast, as you continue to pray, as you continue to worship, I'm telling you, God is going to do something miraculous in your life. I am a living witness. Let me tell you something. Every time I worship God, hallelujah, you know, I get an idea to generate wealth. Deuteronomy 8:18. Let me tell you something. It is God who gives your hands, come on, power to get wealth. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Somebody lift up your hands right now and receive in Jesus' name that God is going to give you an idea from heaven, you know, to change the course of your life. Listen, a lot of people, you're praying for finances, you know, and God, okay, God's saying, I want to give you something in a seed-like form. Hallelujah. And listen to me. When you get that seed from the Lord, it could just be an idea. You know, I need you to make sure it's planted. Hallelujah. And I need you to water it with the word. All right. That's why I'm telling you, people of God. So listen, I just got off track. Excuse me. Proverbs 10:6. Write this down. Proverbs 10:6. It says blessings. Write this down. I'm going to take this word unto God. Blessings crown the head of the righteous. Amen. Blessings crown the head of the righteous, but violence overwhelms the mouth of the wicked. Listen, you are blessed. So therefore, you're walking uprightly. So blessings shall crown your head. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Blessings shall crown our head. All right. So when our ways please God, he will bless you beyond measure. I didn't hear what I just said. When your ways pleases the Lord, he's going to bless you beyond measure. So go ahead, somebody, ask him. Ask him, say, God, give me the best gifts, God. Give me the best gifts, God. Hallelujah. So seek God with your whole heart. And the word of God says you will find him. All right, listen. So Jeremiah 29:13. And this is a word for somebody. God said, I need you to seek me with your whole heart. Jeremiah 29:13. When you seek me, you will find me. When you seek me with your whole heart. That's right. We're going to give it all to God. All the pain, the burdens. Lord God, God, we just don't know. Let me tell you something. A broken and contrite spirit, God will not despise somebody. Amen. Listen, somebody just need to lay prostrate before the Lord and just give it all to God. Don't you know it's a breakthrough in that? Listen, nobody knew my struggle. Do you want to hear what I'm saying to you, people of God? Can I testify? Nobody knew my struggle. For a year and a half, I slept on the floor. I didn't even have a bed. And I remember crying out to God, and I said, God, you know, my secular job, you know, they just cut my hours. I don't know what to do. You know, I'm tired of asking people for money. All my resources, I've been exhausted. God, I don't know what to do. So let me tell you something. I humbled myself. I laid prostrate before the Lord. You know, I cried a little bit. And let me tell you something. When I say the next day God move, the next day God move. I don't think y'all heard what I'm saying to you. The next day God move. I'm praying for God to bless me for 1 month to get my money for storage. But God says, nah, baby. I'm going to eliminate that storage bill. Amen. So that's exactly what God did. He eliminated the storage bill. So the next day after I cried and I teared all night in prayer, let me tell you something, God moved. You know, a pastor from Denver called me and he said, woman of God, he's like, I got some furniture for your house. I'm like, what? You know, so he came to my apartment and he said, where's the rest of your furniture? And I was like, in storage. She's like, what? Well, I have my moving truck out there. Let me go to your storage and get it. So this man, this pastor, went and got all my stuff out of storage and put it in my apartment. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? So listen, people of God, listen. Let me tell you something. You are this close away from getting a breakthrough. Amen. God is saying, I need you to seek me with your whole heart. Seek him. Give it to him. Listen to me. You know, a lot of people right now, you know God is about to move for you because you have an inner peace inside of you. Amen. I feel it right now so clearly. You have an inner peace inside of you. So you know God is getting ready to move. You're not worried about the bill collectors. You're not worried about the people walking out your life. You're not worried about those people, you know, at church backstabbing you. You're not worried because you have peace about it. Even when you wanted to cry, you couldn't even cry because guess what? You know God is with you. You know God is on the scene. You know God is moving for you. That's why you're not even worried about it, because you know that your soul has rest. And we know when your soul has rest, when you prayed about the situation, then you know that God is getting ready to blow your mind. God is getting ready to come through for you. I'm telling you, God is getting ready to do exceedingly abundantly above and beyond anything you can think or and imagine. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Amen. Who feels that inner peace right now? A lot of people, you were frustrated, but then this morning you just felt peace come inside of your spirit, and you're like, man, God, I feel good this morning. Lord God, God, I got things all around me acting up, acting crazy, my kids and this, all this confusion, all these distractions, but God, I have an inner peace. I have an inner knowing, Lord God, that God, something is about to pop off. God, God, you're getting ready to move. God, God, you're getting ready to blow my mind. Lord God, hallelujah. Who knows what I'm talking about? Jesus, that's right. Hallelujah. That's right, Yolanda. Yolanda, hallelujah. Woman of God, hallelujah. I don't know if you got that house, hallelujah, that moving situation, but just get ready. Do you hear what I'm saying to you, Yolanda? Hallelujah. Just get ready, woman of God. Hallelujah. Woo, Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay, Jesus. My God, just get ready. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Hallelujah. Some things are getting ready to be furnished. Amen. Just things in your house are getting ready to be furnished. Hallelujah. Not even at your own expense. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Not even at your own expense. Some things are getting ready to get furnished. Hallelujah. I pray that it's making sense. All right. So, listen, people of God. Jesus. Okay. So, hallelujah, let's receive. I'm telling you, I heard that some things are getting ready to get furnished, not even at your own expense. It's not going to cost you nothing. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? That's what the Lord is getting ready to do for you, woman of God. Hallelujah. So God is a God who honors his word above his name. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? God is a God who honors his word above his name. Let me tell you something, people of God. When we pray this word today, when we speak these declarations out today, you gave away your furniture when you moved. So do you have furniture right now? Amen. Because the word of God says, when we give, it shall be given back to us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall man pour into our bosom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So since you gave, just get ready to receive. Amen. I just heard furnished. Some things are getting ready to be furnished for you. So, whoo, Jesus. All right. So, my God. So God honors his word above his name. So if you walk uprightly, you know, you qualify for a blessing. Amen. You qualify for a blessing. So we're going to remind God of his word, and he's going to honor it. Amen. We're going to remind God. Hallelujah. No, you moved to another state. Okay, so just get ready. You know, get ready for your furniture. Amen. Some things are going to be furnished for you. Amen. I decree it in your life. I'm telling you, receive it. That's right. Receive. Woo, God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, and I just want to pray that you just continue to walk uprightly. Some people, you're getting ready to backslide. We're not going to backslide, amen? Some people just need to repent and cast those thoughts down. See, the devil is trying to speak to some of y'all and say, oh, you know, it's easier in the world. It's easier if you go out and do this. No, it's not easier. Let me tell you something. Why go back? You have come this far. Are you kidding me? Are you really going to go back? Come on, somebody. So, dear Heavenly Father, listen. Lord, we exalt you. Lord, we praise you, Lord. Come on now. Let's pray. Come on now, Jesus. You know, I'm reading out of this book in right standing. This is, I think, the fourth book that I've written. You know, I have 10 books. I got 11th one coming out right now. Walk by Faith, a daily devotional. If you have not pre-ordered that book, I need you to pre-order it. But right now, we're going to pray this morning for your miracle. Amen. We're going to pray right now something powerful. When we touch and agree right now, somebody, you're sick in your body. Somebody has stomach ailments. You couldn't even eat and enjoy Thanksgiving yesterday. If that is you on here, if you're sick and you couldn't even enjoy your dinner yesterday, I need you to lay hands on your belly right now. Hallelujah. I curse acid reflux, indigestion, in the name of Jesus. I curse it at the root. That's you, Samaria. Lord, I curse it at the root. I send forth the fire, God, right now, the touch in Jesus' name. I bind up any sickness on here in Jesus' name. I rebuke that in Jesus' name. I come against nausea and vomiting in Jesus' name. And I decree and declare, hallelujah, woman of God, you're going to begin to eat food again. You're going to be able to digest that food in Jesus' name. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? You're going to digest it. You're going to eat good. I decree it in your life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I hear, you know, back pain. Hallelujah. If you got back pain, you know, I want you to get up underneath this anointing because God wants to heal this morning. And I send forth the fire, God, to touch your back in Jesus' name. I command pain to come out in Jesus' name. Come on, people of God. Hallelujah. Woo, God. Hallelujah. That's you. Feeling back. Get up, woman of God. You know, hallelujah. I send forth fire right now to touch that back and be healed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And let me know what you feel. Let me know, because I feel that anointing on my back for you. Hallelujah, Jesus. My God. See, y'all putting a demand on the anointing. Hallelujah. I'm trying to pray, but I got to follow the Holy Spirit. Somebody right here. Somebody got sore throat pain. Who's this? Somebody got something wrong with your throat. Sore throat pain. God wants to heal you this morning. Hallelujah. Receive it. Receive it. Nasheba. Receive that healing in your back in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody got something wrong with their throat. You're being healed right now in Jesus' name. Come on, people of God. Somebody got some tension right here. Hallelujah. All right here on the right side. You know, that's going to break off for you right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I decree and declare when you get off of here. That's a few of y'all. My God. When you get off the scope. Hallelujah. I feel God touching right now. Hallelujah. You're going to feel heat. You're going to feel warmth. You got sore throat pain. I feel it. You're getting healed right now. Come on. I need you to get up right now. If I'm calling your things out, if I'm calling your illness out, I curse breathing problems at the root. I need you to do something. Stand up. Go walk. Run around. I'm telling you. Lay hands on your head. Your mind is being healed right now. Listen to me, people of God. Hallelujah. Put a demand on God. Put a demand on the anointing. I'm telling you, when you get up and do something in faith, then watch God. All right? Watch the hand of the Lord move. Amen? Get up right now. Let me know if God's touching you, because I feel fire in that throat. That tension is breaking. I feel the fire of God in your back right now. God is healing your back. Hallelujah. Some few people in here with back pain. Hallelujah. So let me know how I'm going to keep on going. Let me know. You felt that. Amen. Amen. How you doing, woman of God? Shanika. Yes. Hallelujah. Let me know if the pain is gone. So God, we exalt you, God. God, we praise you, Lord God. God, we humble ourselves today and we ask you for grace. We ask you for mercy. Somebody on here got carpal tunnel. Who has carpal tunnel? I heard carpal tunnel. Hallelujah. It's in your left wrist. Who's that? Hallelujah. My God, every time you try to sit down and write, it's difficult. And the Lord has been speaking, like, I need you to do some writing. And you just get, that's you. My God. All right, Samaria, I need you to, you know, what do you feel in your wrist? I sent forth the fire of God on that wrist, woman of God. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Yes, the pain is completely gone. Y'all give God praise. Look at God. Shanika, she had pain. I think she said her throat or something was hurting, but God just healed her right now. Woman of God, you're going to feel like tingling in this. I feel some tingling in this left wrist. Jeanette said her throat is healed. Y'all give God praise for these healing miracles. Y'all give God praise. That's right. School of the Prophet starts December 1st. I need you to sign up. Hallelujah. You're going to get impartation. I'm going to impart into you guys. You're going to be the flow. You're going to flow with the Holy Spirit on another level. Hallelujah. That's right. Lay hands on your heart, Jacqueline. I pray that your heart be healed. Oh my God, Jeanette said her right tension shoulder pain is gone. Y'all give God praise for that. Y'all give God praise to that. I pray for Suzanne. I pray hope in her life in Jesus' name. I speak a miracle in her life in Jesus' name. All right, y'all. Hallelujah. So listen, hallelujah. Lord, we repent of our sins today. God, we ask you to forgive us, God. Lord God, Psalms 34:10. Write this down, people of God. I need you to take this word back to God. I need you to take this word back to God. Psalms 34:10. You know, it says the lions grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord will lack no good thing. Continue to seek God. Continue to seek God. The word of God says those who seek the Lord will lack no good thing. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? A lot of people, you've been seeking God. Just get ready. God, I need you, Father God, to demonstrate this word. God, demonstrate this word in Jesus' name, Lord God. Lord God, we ask you, Father God, for the best gift spiritually, God, and naturally, Lord God. We decree and declare we are the righteousness of God through Jesus Christ. God, we ask you, God, that you honor our faith and move mightily, God, on our behalf, Lord God. Lord God, we pray that you bless us tremendously, Lord God, because you will withhold no good thing from us since we walk uprightly. That's right. Amen. Now Sheba said the pain is gone. Look at God. We give God praise. I don't know if she had back pain, but she said, hallelujah. You feel the presence of the Lord on here today. Amen. You feel peace. Look at God. I give God praise. God is here. God is real. Wow. Hallelujah. It's early in the morning, but Jesus, I feel like shouting, man. I feel like praising God up in here. Jesus. Wow. Hallelujah. Y'all celebrate for these people's miracles, because if you, I'm telling you, that's right, God's going to demonstrate his word. If you, I'm telling you, if you celebrate for somebody else, God is looking at your motives and your heart, and you are next. I'm telling you, you're not too far away from receiving your manifestations. That is what I do know. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Every time somebody get blessed around me, I praise God like it's my own miracle. And let me tell you something. God is looking at our heart's motives. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? And just get ready to receive. Amen. Because God is looking at your heart. You know, some people right now, don't take the bait of jealousy. Don't take the bait of envy. When you feel weary and you feel kind of discouraged, and you get, everybody around you is getting blessed, but it seems like you're not getting blessed. But listen to me. God is setting you up. I don't think you heard what I said. I said God is setting you up. Amen. My God, you got to know the God that you serve. You got to know that God is faithful. You got to know that, you know, God is preparing the best for you. Amen. Listen, that blessing was their blessing, but the blessing that God has for you is for you. All right, we're not going to be jealous of one another. See, the kingdom of the body of Christ is already coming against enough division already. We're not going to even be used as the best of the enemy to cause even more further division. We're not going to be used by the enemy to cause further division. I rebuke that in Jesus' name. No, we're going to walk uprightly before God. Amen. We're going to celebrate one another. Listen, we're all members. We're all different members, but one body. Amen. Listen to me, people of God. We need to celebrate our brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. So many people, you know, it's crazy and it's really sad that when they see you advancing, when they see God enlarging you, you know, not everybody's happy for you. I rebuke that jealous spirit in the name of Jesus. That's right. Jealousy is as cruel as the grave. All right. So, you know, God, we thank you in advance, God. We thank you in advance, Lord God. That's right. We need to pray for one another. That's right. We need to pray for one another and earnestly, you know, lift each other up in prayer. You don't know what somebody else is going through. Just because they look happy on the outside doesn't mean that they're happy in the inside. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? Lift that people up. Lift your brothers and sisters up in Christ today. Amen. Pray for them. All right, so we thank you in advance, God, for our harvest, God. We thank you in advance, God, for our breakthrough, God. God, we thank you in advance for manifestations, Lord God, of our miracles. Thank you for answering our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. So I read out of my book, In Right Standing. I read off of page 93. If you got the book, you can get these books on Amazon.com. You can go to my website, which is on my profile, KimberlyHargress.com, and get the book. I've written 10 awesome books. I've written my 11th one, Walk by Faith, the Daily Devotional. I need you guys to pre-order the book. Amen. Listen, hallelujah. I got 2 conferences coming up. You know, I got a conference next month. My church, Grace Be Unto You. All right? I need you to register. It's a prophetic prayer watch conference. You know, we need to get together and we need to pray more. A lot of people, they don't want to come to prayer meetings, you know, but if it was a prophetic meeting, everybody want to come and run and knock down the door. But when I say let's get together and pray, you know, people are like, listen. But when I say the glory of God's going to come, the glory of God's going to come to that meeting. Amen. And I'm going to give away prizes and giveaways to at that conference. So register. All right. I have another conference February the 25th at my church, Grace Be Unto You. It's a woman's conference. It's called Empowering the New Me Women's Conference. Listen, it's going to go down. I'm going to release my brand new book. It's going to be my 12th book, you know, 50 Tips to Becoming a Godly Woman. Listen, you know, I used to be a stripper. I used to be the biggest fornicator, the biggest liar. But look at me now. I'm a woman of God. I practice righteousness. I live holy. I walk rightly before the Lord. Amen. So God gave me 50 things to empower the women of God. And I want to impart that thing into you. You're going to get a t-shirt when you register. It's February the 25th. It's a Saturday. You're going to get a t-shirt when you register. You're going to get some lunch and lots of snacks throughout the day, because I like to eat sometimes, my God. And then you're going to we're going to be giving away makeup, and, you know, you're going to get prophetic ministry. You're going to know your purpose and will and the call of God on your life. You're going to get impartation, all right? And you're going to get some deliverance ministry. I'm in Colorado. I'm in Colorado Springs, amen? You can find more about me on my website, all right? Just go on the profile and look that up, all right? Sign up for the School of the Prophets December 1st, amen? Class start, I think, in like 2 weeks or next week. I need you to sign up December 1st. You know, if you want to know more about the prophetic, if you desire to prophesy, you know, I can activate you. I can push you. I can train you. All right. I'll get you flowing with the Holy Spirit. Register for that. All right. It is a one-time fee. And once you pay the fee, you can retake it over and over and over and over again if you need to. All right. So I got a lot of good things coming up. Next year, I got a prophetic summit coming up. All right. So I want to see you guys. I want to impart into you guys. I got, you know, 2 prayer CDs. Hallelujah. If you want me to touch and agree with you for your miracle, you can get my CD on my store, my website. I got another one, Birth and Prophets in the Wilderness. All right. Hallelujah. But I got to go. My kids just got here. So God bless you. I'm going to try to come back on later and do some teaching about the prophetic. We're going to finish up our series on Amos. All right. God bless you. Yes. Send me your prayer requests. Send me your prayer requests. I got to go because my kids are at the door. They're knocking. All right. Send me your prayer requests. And I know you're healed, Samira. You're healed. By Jesus' stripes, you are healed. God bless you.